We buried old Bob where the blood would sway. At the foot of the Eagle Hawk, we fashioned a cross from the old man's grave, for fear that his ghost might walk. We carved his name on a bloodwood tree with the date of his sad decease, and in place of died from a vexed spree, we wrote, "May he rest in peace." For Bob was known on the overland, a regular old bushwhack, tramping along in the dust and sand, humping his well-worn sway. He would camp for days on the riverbed and loiter and fish for whales. "I'm into the swagman's yard," he said, "I never shall find the rails." But he found the rails on that summer night, for better place or worse. As we watched by turns in the flickering light, with an old black gin finer, the breeze came in with the scent of pine. The river sounded clear when a change came on and we saw the sign that told us the end was near. He spoke in a cultured voice and low, "I fancy they've sent the route. I once was an army man, you know. Though now I'm a drunken brute. But bury me out where the bloodwoods wave. And if ever you're fairly stuck, just take and shovel me out of the grave, and maybe I'll bring you luck." For I've always heard his voice squeak, his strength was well nigh spent. He gasped and struggled and tried to, then fell in a moment dead. Thus ended a wasted life and heart of energies misapplied. Old Bob was out of the swagman's yard and over the great divide. Drought came down on the
children flock. And never a raindrop fell. Though the tortured moans of the starving stock might soften a fiend from hell. And we thought of the hint that the swagman gave when he went to the great unseen. So we shoveled the skeleton out of the grave to see what is in my. Yeah, we dug where the cross and the grave posts were. Then we shoveled away the mold. When sudden a vein of quartz lay bare, all gleaming with yellow gold. 'Twas a reef with never fall. That ran from the ranger's crest, and the richest